And welcome to At the Van Wezel. I'm Mary Bensel, the executive director of the Van Wezel Performing Arts Hall, and I'm here with my lovely, lovely marketing director, Julia Mays, who has so much of a great time with me at shows, and we've just been having a great year this year, haven't we, Jules?
It is. It's been fabulous, and everybody's really enjoying it also, I think.
You know, yeah.
Getting the fun out there.
And folks, we have a couple of shows to announce, but you know what? One
a
of the
couple.
Shows may not have tickets left by the time you see this show.
But I got something I want to interrupt really quick because I have something exciting to say to the public, and I'm very proud of our executive director, Mary Bensel. She has gotten an honorable congressional award from Congressman Vern Buchanan at our foundation gala, and it was exciting.
Yeah, it's the honorary Vern Buchanan.
Yes.
And it was a congressional proclamation, and he was thanking me for, and quite frankly, our foundation that does so much to help the education department. We're very responsible for this, and it's a lovely story that they had, and it was for thanking us for all of our education programs and also for the economic impact that the hall brings to the area and for the shows.
And that's so important, I think.
And he was so wonderful and nice, and he's so supportive of the arts, so I really appreciate it, and I appreciate our foundation. And with that, we serve numerous thousands of students and older students too, not just young ones,
sure,
but older ones. But thank you, Julia. It was a surprise and a great honor.
And it's on display in our main lobby now.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, so
but I was very, very thrilled.
Good.
But thank
that's
you.
Exciting.
But to our new shows, and like I started to say, one Harry Connick Jr., which I have been chasing him for so long, I can't tell you. And I don't mean figuratively, I mean chasing the show. But I'd be willing to chase him too, Jules.
For 3 years,
oh
I
my
know,
gosh.
Right?
And he is coming April the 7th. And, you know, the first hour we put tickets on sale, it was like huge. It was over almost $60,000 sold. So
we're
hopeful that that's a big sellout. And then we're adding another show that I think folks should be thrilled about, Cirque Illumination. I saw the show up in Tampa. At the David Strauss Center, and it's the same fabulous troupe that put on Cirque Holidays, and they're going to be here for one night on April 19th, and it was a situation where it was a last-minute add-on. This is exciting. This show is just full of art, circus, and it's
got
two
performances of that?
We're just doing one right now,
and
they're fitting it in between coming from Melbourne and West Palm, and so that should be great. But let's talk about what's going on in March.
Yes.
What's first up?
Our first show is An Evening with Lucille Ball, one of my very favorite redheads, and very funny, directed by Lucy Arnaz, and starring Suzanne, I'm going to slaughter this name, LaRouche.
Suzanne LaRouche, I think.
LaRouche, okay.
And we have a little video, and this show, by the way, folks, is directed by Lucy Arnaz, and Lucy Arnaz, of course, is the daughter of Lucille Ball. So let's just see a little clip.
What if you made Desi the husband in the television show? Then he'd be stuck here with me. Now listen, he's a good actor, and he's funny. What do you mean America won't believe I'm married to a Cuban? I am married to a Cuban.
All right, Michael Amonte. Mm. The women in my office are going wild.
Well, I'm one of them.
I know. I wasn't going to tell, but Michael Amonte has been here before. He is gorgeous. I mean, his picture alone, women are just dropping, looking at it. And he's doing a tribute to Luciano Pavarotti. He is coming on March 2nd. And the interesting backstage story I have about Michael is, I've presented him many times in an Italian festival. And normally what happens is the opening acts go on first, and then the star comes on last. And I'm not going to mention the star, but Michael Amonte was bringing down the house so much, the people were going wild, jumping to their feet, because he has one of the most gorgeous voices I've ever heard. And so the star got mad, and we had to put Michael Amonte in the star slot and put the star as the opener because he was too upset to go on after him.
That.
So it's a show that we would really like to
He does have
see.
A beautiful voice.
So So what's up next, Jules?
What's up next is Barrage. And that is a string quartet. They play eclectic music. It's very exciting. I mean, they kind of mix pop, gospel, and it's, I think it's for all genres.
And I think a quartet is almost a bad word because it, you know, what it is they play the fiddle like nobody I've ever seen.
Right.
And if you enjoyed Bowfire and those kinds of shows, or, you know, in Riverdance when you saw the fiddle players, they really, really are exciting. And we have great tickets for that. And Barrage, let's just let you take your own opinion of what Barrage is. Let's see something. All right, you are a Dukes of Dixieland fan.
I am a Dukes of Dixieland band fan.
Band fan.
Band fan.
You're a band fan.
And that
fan.
Too. that's going to be so exciting. I mean, they really, they have traditional jazz. It's kind of got a New Orleans flavor mixed with the authentic New Orleans music, and I'm very excited to see them.
That's why it's
and
so
they're
cool.
They're a crossover.
It's really cool to be here, folks, because one minute, you know, you're seeing Barrage, the next minute, Dukes of Dixieland, that's on March 5th, and then we go to another show, Frank Sinatra Jr., and it's so funny, if you saw the new Jim Belushi television show, they kept through the whole show saying, the hottest ticket in town is Junior, Junior, and I thought he was a rapper, and it actually was Frank Sinatra Jr., and he not only sounds like his dad, he now eerily looks like his dad. And, you know, we had so many great stories recently from Shirley MacLaine, who was here, about the Sinatra era, so I wouldn't miss Junior, and I would say get your tickets today,
yeah,
wouldn't
absolutely.
You?
Absolutely, get in with the in crowd.
Get in with the in crowd. And then one of our perennial favorites here is Johnny Mathis. Chances are. Now don't come because
when
I'm
When Sunny gets blue.
There you go.
There
and
you go.
Johnny is almost sold out. But folks, even if we are sold out, get on the waiting list.
And we promise we won't sing that night.
And we won't sing, please. We won't. And then we have one of the greatest orchestras, I think, in the United States. The Boston Pops are coming with Keith Lockhart. And that's on March 15th, another near sellout, if not sold out. Again, a waiting list possibility. And I think it's wonderful. And then a fabulous, fabulous female singer, a songstress, Natalie Cole, March the 16th. Natalie has been here several times before. Last time she was here, she sang while she was on dialysis, while she was waiting for a kidney transplant.
She's actually ill.
She's all well now. She's gorgeous. She's beautiful. She actually sings on tape with her father. It's really, really fabulous. And then we're going to end with one of our cameramen's favorite shows, REO Speedwagon. On March the 17th, we've added this show. And so there are great tickets still left. 13 top 40 songs. Can you name some of them?
Oh gosh, I knew you were going to ask me.
Well,
that.
I know.
No,
if you
I made
don't.
Sure I did Three Dog Night so that when you asked
well,
me that.
Well, I know, I know. Okay, can't fight this feeling anymore. Take It on the Run. Keep on Loving You. Keep the Fire Burning. That Ain't Love. In My Dreams. I mean, need I say more? This is rock and roll genius. These were people that just women went wild about. It was classic rock. It was fabulous. And all of these tickets can be bought at our website, www.vanwazel.org. Call the box office, 953-3368. Or, folks, the cheapest way to buy a ticket and avoid the phone or online fees is to come down to the box office, meet our lovely staff, and you can pick out your seats right there. We also are on Twitter, we're on Facebook.
We're everywhere.
YouTube you're getting on, we're having a newsletter. Join our email blast club because that's how people heard about Harry Connick the fastest. But we will be back in just a minute with one of our sponsors to tell you something about Leecom. And welcome back to At the Van Wezel. And I would like to introduce Michael Pollan, who has joined me from, now I'm going to try to get this name correct, Lake Erie College of Osteopathic Medicine.
You got it.
Wow. And you're commonly known as LECOM, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And you are sponsoring Michael Amonte, which is coming up. We were talked about him. He has the most gorgeous voice. You're going to enjoy it.
We're very excited to be a sponsor of that event. Our president, Dr. John Ferretti, and our provost, Dr. Sylvia Ferretti, are coming from Erie, Pennsylvania.
Oh, my gosh. That's wonderful.
To see the show and see Michael.
Or are they just coming because it's, you know, 45 below up there?
Exactly.
But we're glad they're coming because he's marvelous. But LECOM, what exactly is LECOM?
LECOM is, as Mary said, is the Lake Erie College of Osteopathic Medicine. We are part of the largest medical school in the country.
Wow.
We have three campuses, two in Pennsylvania and one in Florida, in Bradenton on Lakewood Ranch Boulevard. And
wow.
We are training the next generation of physicians and pharmacists.
Well, you have a connection to me. I'm from Pennsylvania, and I'm running a house in Lakewood Ranch, so it all fits for me.
Terrific.
But I think it's fabulous that you're training physicians. And osteopathic medicine, what does that mean, osteopathic?
It's more of a holistic approach to medicine. There are two types of doctors. You have your MDs and your DOs. We're training DOs, which are doctors of osteopathic mm-hmm. medicine. As far as the training goes, there is no difference between an MD and a DO. DOs can do the same exact things that MDs can do. It's the same exact training. The only difference is that DOs have a specialized training called OMM, Osteopathic Manual Manipulative Medicine, and it's more of a hands-on mm-hmm. approach to diagnosing patients. So
patients.
It's just another trick that a doctor has in his or her bag.
I've seen a DO, and it really gives it a whole another area, and it's helpful. And people shouldn't be scared because the DO initials versus the MD, because it means they have everything the MDs have and a little more.
Absolutely right. Absolutely correct.
Well, tell me about, do you have programs here, and how many students are here?
We have enrolled currently 600 medical students
wow.
and 400 pharmacy students. Our medical students come from all over the country. A little less than half are from Florida, but the goal of LECOM here in Florida is to train the students here and to have them do their residencies here. Where students do their residencies, they're more apt to train. So
mm-hmm.
we're hoping to keep the students.
And keep them here because
exactly.
healthcare is certainly a hot button topic here in the South, you know, where we have a lot of people seeking care, you know, as seniors move here or Arizona or wherever. So it's wonderful to try to bring young professionals into this area.
Absolutely. There's a major physician shortage in Florida, and that's why LECOM in 2004 came to Bradenton. To open up LECOM. So as I said, we have three campuses, one in Erie, Pennsylvania, one in Greensburg, Pennsylvania, and then here in Bradenton.
Where's Greensburg?
That is about 45 minutes outside of Pittsburgh.
Oh, I went to grad school in Pittsburgh. So that's I'm really very thrilled. And do you have any plans to expand here in Florida?
Yes, we do. In 2012, we'll be opening up the LECOM School of Dental Medicine.
Wow.
We hope to have a groundbreaking in May or June. And we will be enrolling our first class of future dentists in 2012.
Now, will these dentists